Hello everyone, welcome back to Geology Simplified. So we are continuing with the practice questions for GSI exam for the general studies. This is the Polity part 2. Let's jump to the questions. Like from the previous video, these are only questions in the form of statements. There will not be any options. So we'll see the first question. Which parts of the Indian Constitution provide economic justice as an objective? Then, which part of the Indian Constitution, notice the part here, because Indian Constitution is composed of certain parts. So, which part of Indian Constitution deals with the fundamental rights? So we have to give the part number. Then, which human right is protected by Article 21? This is a very important article, one of the most evolved articles. So, what is Article 21? Then, which fundamental rights cannot be suspended even during an emergency? So there are only two articles which cannot be suspended. Is right to property a fundamental right? We'll see. If you know, it is well and good. And which fundamental right was described by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as the heart and soul of the Constitution? Who is the guardian, protector, or guarantor of fundamental rights? Which body? Again, Article 21A, notice the difference, was included in the Constitution by which Constitutional Amendment Act? So Article 21 is separate from Article 21. We'll see which one. How many categories of fundamental rights are provided in the Indian Constitution? We'll see these. Which fundamental rights are available only to Indian citizens, not to foreigners? We'll see the article numbers for these two. So now you can pause here and answer for yourself, or we'll jump on to the answers then. Let's see. Which parts of the Indian Constitution provide economic justice as an objective? So economic justice is provided in preamble, verbatim, and DPSP, that is directive principles of state policy. Directive principles of state policy, that is, these are the guiding principles which are given to the state. These are some ideal principles which could not be included in the fundamental rights, because fundamental rights are justiciable. That is, you can go to the court if they are violated. But DPSPs are certain ideal principles that the state should adhere to while framing the policies. But DPSPs are not justiciable. So economic justice is present under preamble as well as DPSP. Whereas fundamental rights has political justice. So political, social, and economic justice is covered by DPSPs. That is okay. So then moving forward, which part of the Indian Constitution deals with fundamental rights? So that is the part 3 of the Indian Constitution. So if just to have a brief, so there are various parts in the Constitution. Like part 1 deals with the Union and its territories. Part 2 is about citizenship. Part 3 is fundamental rights. Part 4 is the directive principles of state policy. Part 4A is fundamental duties. So similarly, there are many parts. You can see through them, at least remember the part names. It might not be easy to remember in the first go, but then you can remember at least the important ones. So part 3 is fundamental rights. Then, which human right is protected by Article 21? So it is the right to life and personal liberty, of the most important fundamental rights present in the Indian Constitution and also fundamental rights chapter. Which fundamental rights cannot be suspended during an emergency? So Article 20 and 21. So Article 20 is protection in respect of conviction, and 21, as we just mentioned, is life and personal liberty. So Article 20 has actually three clauses. The clause will be ex post facto. There can be no law which can criminalize offense from back date. Then second is there can be no double jeopardy. That is, you cannot be punished for the same crime twice. You can only be punished once. Then clause 3 under Article 20 is self-incriminating, that you cannot be forced to give be a witness against yourself. So this clause 3 is self-incriminating clause. You cannot incriminate yourself. So these are the three rights under Article 20 and 21 is right to life. So these cannot be suspended even during an emergency. Let's move forward. Is right to property a fundamental right? No. It used to be earlier. It was included in Article 19(1)(f). But now it was omitted by the 44th Constitutional Amendment Act that came in 1978. So this 44th Constitutional Amendment Act actually included a separate article, that is Article 300A, and made right to property a legal or constitutional right. So it is no more a fundamental right, but it is a legal right. That is clear. Let's move forward. Which article is described as, which fundamental right is described as the heart and soul of the Constitution? This was described by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The right is right to constitutional remedies. This is the most important right with respect to enforcing the fundamental rights, because this is the right which gives you the option to go to the court of law for the enforcement of the fundamental rights. So this right in itself being made a fundamental right. So that is why it is very important. Who is this guardian, protector and guarantor of fundamental rights? So it is the Supreme Court of India. Now why Supreme Court of India? Because this Article 32 gives you the right to directly approach the Supreme Court for any violation of the fundamental rights, and Supreme Court has to entertain the petition. It has to entertain the writ petition. You can also approach high courts, but it is up to them to accept or not. Whereas Supreme Court has to accept in case of fundamental rights violation. That is why it is the guardian of the fundamental rights. Moving forward, Article 21 was included in the Constitution by which Constitutional Amendment Act? So Article 21, first of all, is the right to education. This article was included by the 86th Constitution Amendment Act in 2002. Later, it was enforced by a law, that is Right to Education for Children Law in 2009. So this is the enabling provision, which is Article 21. So this is the latest inclusion in the fundamental rights. Apart from the enabling provision, which has been added in Article 16 to incorporate the EWS reservation quota. But anyway, let's not go into that much detail. So how many categories of fundamental rights are provided? Very important categories of fundamental rights. At least you should remember the categories, and then if you can remember various fundamental rights, it will be good for you. So categories, there are six categories. So let's see one by one. 14 to 18 is the right to equality. Then 19 to 22 is the right to freedom. Freedom of speech, expression, various kinds. Then right against exploitation, right against, this is the right against bonded labor. And it also incorporates child labor, so things like that. Right to freedom of religion. Then two are the cultural and educational rights. So this is 29 and 30. These are for mostly for any minorities or any group with a separate identity. So then Article 32 is for, as we said, it is a right to itself, that is the right to constitutional remedies. So these are the six categories. There are various rights under this, under each article. So if you can get a hold of each article, starting from 14 to right up to 32 or even 35, that will be a very good learning for you, because there are chances that one or the other fundamental right may be asked. So coming on to the last question, which fundamental rights are available only to Indian citizens and not to foreigners? So those are these five rights under these five articles: Article 15, 16, 19, then 29, 30. Do remember these, at least the article numbers. So Article 15 is prohibition of discrimination based on race, religion, caste, and all. And Article 16 is equality of opportunity in public employment. 19 is again right to freedom of various kinds, right to freedom of speech and all, assembly, association. Then 29 and 30, just as we just now mentioned, are cultural and educational rights, mostly for minorities. So this is it for this video. Again, do share, because it will help others. You can revise some questions, get some question practice from this, and Trust us, some of the questions are maybe asked, may not be asked, but anyway, you should keep your preparation to the optimum level. And also let us know in the comment section if these are videos are helpful so that we can make more of them. This is our Telegram channel link. Do subscribe to us there because it is a easier platform to share content there. And so follow our Facebook page and subscribe to the YouTube channel for more such videos. Until next time, bye-bye.